Good fishing, Zach. We've caught something to brag about now. In all the history of the FBI, I'm probably the only one who fished out documents thrown into a waterfall. Don't you think so, Zach?
I just don't believe it. Files from a waterfall. What does that all mean?
It's called The Legend of the New Raincoat Killer. George, have you ever seen this handwriting?
Yes. It's Thomas's.
George, I need to take these documents to Harry. He said he'd tell me everything once I take the docs to him.
Those are classified. I can't allow a civilian to view them. Especially that deranged old goat who owns most of the town.
I agree with George. Harry is... how can I put it? He might be dangerous.
You don't need to worry. You said it yourselves, didn't you? There has never been a mass murder case in this town. That means these documents pertain to a case that never actually happened. Just look at it as though they never actually existed either.
Ridiculous.
York, I'm sure you've got a plan or something in mind? Okay, you have my approval.
George, are you sure?
Emily, we need to continue looking for Thomas. Our search may just have become a hunt.
Yes, get on it. I'll go see Harry alone.
Okay.
I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't seen it for myself. But Thomas?
There's got to be a rational explanation for this.
Zach, George has started to change. I think the deaths of Becky and Diane had a deep effect on him. I guess this town truly is without a king now. Okay then, Zach. Let's pay Harry another visit and get to the bottom of all this. I have to admit, I do like spending a bit of time investigating alone. I'm getting a bit sick of being told that I'm either too slow or too fast. You agree with me, right, Zach? So, where shall we go next? Zach, we can take a rest if you're tired. Thank you. Zach, did you want to go somewhere before we visit Harry? That's fine by me. Zach, if you notice anything, just stop me.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Looks like the next game is hide and seek. Huh?
These girls, Zach. Do you see the resemblance? Anna, Becky, she looks like Diane, and Carol. Zach, look. Emily.
No. Destroy. I swore.
Thank you.
Huh?
Emily!
At times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist. Even if it means losing someone that you love.
Stop!
Zack, did you see that? I must be getting tired. Zack, looks like we're out of the countryside and back in civilization.
Welcome, York.
I brought the documents.
Just what is going on in here?
I warned you about haste. Take it slow. You'll lose sight of what's important if you just rush past it. As an agent of the FBI, I'm sure you know. So many people have got it all wrong. They think speed is the key. That being first is the best. They want speed. Satisfied with what the speed brings, even if it means that they miss so much on the way, they don't even see that. I see everything that they don't. From here, I see it all. Then, when the time comes, I make use of what I've seen. I can get whatever I want in this way, anything at all.
You're certainly talkative today, Harry. But I didn't come here for a business lecture. Tell me everything you know.
Speed is not important. Timing is what is important. Timing. York, you have a natural gift for waiting for the correct timing. Just be careful that your haste does not ruin everything. That will be vital to solving the current case at hand. York, I know more than you think, but less than what you hope. One, you have naked custody. Two, Thomas is missing. Three, Carol has a locket that belongs to the murderer. I also know that this case revolves around the Red Seeds. But that's about it.
So you've got an inside line on police information.
That reminds me. The victim's tongues were cut out, weren't they? But that's only a minor point. Don't let the shocks blind you to what's more important. That's another business tip.
Harry, I'm impressed. You gather information really well. You hacked into the FBI network, too. Amazing. But I didn't come here to hear this.
Then let us close the business seminar. It's time for a history lesson instead. As though it were yesterday, if you'll pardon the cliche. It was dark, raining, a foggy night. My parents, who normally got along, were fighting over something. My father was blaming my mother, it seemed. So I left the house, headed for the clock tower. There was a party being held that day to celebrate the tower's completion. I wanted to see the town from above, and so I decided to climb the tower. Curious child, and saw it being constructed day after day. I'm not sure why, but I was really drawn to the tower in some way. And that's why I knew. From the pit in the theater, there's a path to the clock tower. They were just cleaning up after the party, so it was easy to get into the theater. I used the secret passage to sneak into the tower. But when I reached the top, I saw something very strange. There were soldiers there, all wearing gas masks. Device was emitting purple smoke outside. Just then, for the first time, the bell rang throughout the tower. I reacted with fear and left the tower as fast as I could. When I got outside again, the purple fog was spreading. I covered my nose and mouth and ran home. I unconsciously counted the number of times the bell rang. After the 12th time, the bell did not stop ringing. It rang a loud 13th time. Thank you. The following morning, I awoke surrounded by dead bodies. It wasn't raining anymore, and the purple fog was gone. I couldn't believe what I saw and what I myself had done. But even worse things were waiting for me when I got home. My mother was dead. Killed, presumably, also by my father. The next day, the town was overrun by military personnel. That's when the gag order was issued. Talking about the incident was unappreciated, a taboo. But even still, people stopped going outside when it rained. Country folk are very patriotic. We never tell our children about what happened. But these things find a way out of even the tightest of lips, in parts. People only speak of the killer in the red raincoat, which is where the legend of the raincoat killer comes from.
Quite a story.
After the incident, the gas seeped into the soil of the town. Even today, when it rains, a minute amount is released. That's why I never take my mask off when I'm outside. This town is dirty, York.
If what you say is true, then the killer is someone who is badly affected when it rains.
You need to draw the conclusions, not I. I have no conclusions.
Is there a connection between the red seeds and the gas, then?
This is just my own presumption. The seeds and the gas have a similar effect on our nervous systems. I believe someone figured that out and decided to use it. Or it could just be nature's way of getting back at us humans. York! Good news! You'll hear from George soon. They have found Thomas. I'll tell you one last and very important thing. Just as you suspected, everything I have told you is gibberish. I never hacked into the FBI server, and I certainly know nothing about the red seeds. I shall thank you for listening to an old man babble on.
Let me ask you one thing then, Harry. You're a businessman. You must be after something in return for giving me this information.
York, at times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist. Even if it means losing someone that you love.
That still does not justify murder.
Remember this. Everything changes in form. There isn't a single thing that can maintain its shape for eternity. Overlook this fact, you're making a big, big mistake.
¶¶